right, guys, we're starting off a little different today. First, we're eating personal, then we're getting pottery. So, we took this family cruise back in October, and I've had this footage sitting around, and it just never quite felt like the right video to edit. And so I have not done that yet, and so I'm doing it now. But before our cruise, I was able to see a few relatives, including my grandpa, who I hadn't seen in a while because he was too old to travel. He's 95, and we just never got over there too much. And anyway, so I was able to see him before, and I actually left a duck at his house, and he was happy with it. And I brought in some other pottery, and I told him about this video, and he thought it was cool, and all my plans with hiding the ducks and things. And so it was really fun to see him. And then between here and there, right before Christmas, he died. And we just had his funeral last week. So I want to dedicate this one to him. Here's me with my grandpa. So this one's for you, Grandpa. Let's get into the pottery. Hi, guys. I'm going on a cruise very soon. And the big thing cruising now is leaving rubber ducks and finding rubber ducks all over the ship. And so I was like, hey, that sounds fun. Let's do that. I've got young kids, and so they would love that too. And I hear the adults get like super duper crazy into it. And there's all like all sorts of different ducks and stuff. So I thought, hey, that sounds like fun. And so let's try it. So I have these little mini rubber ducks that I totally stole out of my kids' bath. And they weren't in the bath at the time. It was fine. And I'm going to make a cast of these. Anyway, I'm going to get going, and I've never done this before. I watched like one tutorial and I'm just gonna wing it. So let's go. So you're gonna get the super duper summarized version of how I made these ducks because it took me quite a while and I wanna have time to get to some other fun stuff like my kids hiding ducks all over the cruise ship. That was super fun. So here's the gist of how I made these ducks. First, I made a mold container out of cardboard, tape, and foil. I'm sure this is not the recommended method, but I made it work. There we go. One sort of working mold form situation. And both ducks fit in there just fine. I'm going to put a little piece of tape on the bottom of these ducks. They have a hole in them. And my kids were like, but our ducks. I'm like, I'm going to give it back. You're fine. Then I started making the actual mold. I pressed clay into the container that I'd made and pushed the little rubber ducks into the clay. It was slightly tricky getting the ducks into the clay without just smashing them as they're squishy, but it worked out. Then I mixed up some plaster. This started out with me measuring amounts and ended up with me just kind of making the consistency look good. I don't recommend that, but hey, it worked out in the end. I made divots in the clay so I'd have little nubs that I could use to line up the mold correctly later, and then I poured the plaster in and let it set for a while. All right, so this has been sitting here for 20 minutes now, hardening up a bit, and we'll see if it actually worked out at all. I'm going to unmold it, and we'll see what we got here. After the plaster set, I pulled apart the container, removed the clay, put half of the mold back into the container, and then used more plaster over the top. Once the mold set up, it was ready to use. All right, it is now the next day, just because I was busy. This sets up in like half an hour, but I had other stuff to do. All right, let's see if it worked. Oh no, it is not separating. Huh. Okay, actually, it looked totally hopeless because the mold kind of stuck together on the edges and I had to pry it open. But in the end, I had a not terribly professional looking, but mostly functional mold. Good enough.
Whoa. I shifted stuff massively. Wait a second. Oh my gosh. Did I seriously just save that? Okay. So that got, you know, taken into there, but I still have these two, so I can still line it up. Oh my gosh, I think it actually worked. Look at that. Okay, it needs some cleanup, but that is a two-part duck mold. Oh my gosh. Oh, I really, really thought it was just a goner. Oh man. Wow, okay. Nice. So I will try this out later. Let it hopefully solidify a bit more, because it still feels wet. Hi guys, I've been trying out my mold and it works pretty darn well. Look at these little guys. Yes, they need some cleanup. But they're super cute. All right, so I'm making some at home before my trip so I can take them with me and hide them around the ship.
Then I added clay to both halves of the mold by pressing small balls of clay in and then scraping off the excess. Then I scored and used vinegar to attach the two halves as I pressed the mold together. And hey, it worked! Oh my goodness, it actually worked. They needed a decent amount of cleanup and it was pretty far from perfect, but for not really knowing what I was doing, hey, I think I did pretty great. So I made a bunch more of the little ducks and cleaned them up and added some color and details. I used colored slip for the yellow of the ducks. I just added yellow mason stain to slip and brushed it on. Kind of ended up like a paint consistency, but wasn't actually paint. Since it was just colored clay, I could even put the color on the bottom since it wouldn't stick to the kiln shelf like glaze would. For the eyes and the beaks, I used Stroke and Coat, which is a stable glaze. I added all the color and glaze while they were still wet, and then I dried them in my oven, which is not normal for me. Normally I don't rush drying since it can lead to problems like cracks, but I was really short on time, so I risked it. These were small, so it worked out okay, but I certainly would not try that on anything bigger or more complex. Then I fired them in my kiln, and they all turned out so cute. I may have unloaded them from the kiln about, you know, like 10 minutes before we left our house to go on our vacation, but hey, it all worked out. Now it was finally time for the cruise. We had so much fun. My husband and I went on this cruise with our three living kiddos and my parents. My parents have been on a whole lot of cruises. It was my 10th cruise and my husband's second, but it was our first cruise for our kids. They were so excited. We all loved checking out the ship and enjoying different foods. We loved exploring in the ports that we went to and just generally having a fun vacation together. My kids loved being able to order anything they wanted to in the dining room and were frequently seen ordering many, many different entrees and trying all of them. And we enjoy the shows as well. Anyway, if you haven't been on a cruise, this is not an ad for cruises. But if you haven't been on one, you're kind of missing out. I like them. Anyway, so our kids found quite a few of these rubber ducks each around the ship that other people had hidden, which was super fun. That was a bit of a highlight for them. And then it was time to hide the little ducks that I had made. Here we are on the cruise ship. This is the view from our cabin, and we're having a bit of a storm today. This lifeboat right here. But we've got lots of pretty view still. And it is time to go hide some ducks. My kids love them so much that they each kept one, but most of the rest of them got hidden around the ship. I also added my business card, you know, free advertising, right? It was really fun watching my kids think through and choose just the right spots to hide the ducks. The spots couldn't be too hidden or they wouldn't be found, and the point of hiding them was so they somebody could find them. They couldn't be so obvious that they weren't any fun to hide. I mean, who wants to hide it in plain sight? They couldn't be anywhere that might get stepped on because they are actually breakable. And my kids had to be sneaky when hiding them so they weren't be seen by any passing passengers. And, things like that. So they had a lot of fun with that. They did such a great job hiding them and they had so much fun doing it. I know you can't see their faces because, you know, privacy and all, but are my kids the cutest? They're so cute. So we hid them all around the common areas like the atrium, on the side of the stairs, the buffet. I think one ended up on a door handle because they're small. You know, just other public areas like that and by the shops, things like that. We took mental note of where they were hidden, and then we checked back later in the cruise, and they were all gone. They were snatched up immediately, apparently, even though some of them were pretty hidden. I hope they brought a smile to people's faces. I know I had fun making them, and my kids sure had a blast hiding them. Oh, hey, and I have another quick cruise story for you. Before the cruise, I bought a mini pottery wheel so that I could throw pottery on the ship. How crazy is that? Do I do wacky things just for fun? Yes, I do. Okay. Anyway, I got some really funny looks when I was throwing in the buffet. And I got some especially funny looks as I'm carrying my thrown pot and my wheel back to our cabin. I ended up talking a bit with the curious people in the elevator because they were like, "What is that? What are you doing?" You know? Anyway, so I talked to them and they thought it was really, really neat and stuff. But as I walked off to my deck and I could hear the elevator doors were closing, one of the women commented pretty loudly, "That's so cool!" So, hey, funny little moment there. But, hey, I can say I threw pottery at sea now, which is pretty cool indeed. Anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And be sure to check out my other videos, because occasionally I do some pretty weird stuff. Anyway, see you next time, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye.